evening and welcome to the high school spring choir concert. My name is Grant Carmichael. I have the pleasure of working with these fine individuals each rehearsal, and I'm excited to share with what I get to hear every day with you all. Thank you for being in attendance tonight, both in person and on the live stream. Thanks for making time for these students and their passions and their talents. I wanted to remind you all that tonight's concert will be professionally recorded, and so in lieu of that, would you mind just taking out that device that you brought in with you and making sure it went on to that silent mode or turned off so that you can enjoy and we can share with you all of our music. Parents, please keep any youngest members of our audience close at all times, since the singers will be moving around the auditorium throughout tonight's concert. If you need to, please also exit during a song's ending or beginning right before the end of a song, or right before the beginning of a song, or right at the end of a song during the applause. It's the best time to leave or enter. The only exception to that would be if one of those youngest members of our audience is starting to cry out or something like that. Feel free to use the lobby. There is a TV that's in there that will broadcast the same live feed, so you can use that as well to still see the concert. And then any necessary conversation, you can just do that in between performances as well. Again, thank you for being here, and thank you for engaging with these incredible students. As you're listening to the songs tonight, as you're listening to the performers, if you hear something that you enjoy or something that you really like, feel free to meet that with applause. That's what really keeps us energized and motivated. Or a woo! That also helps us too. Some of the things that you'll hear tonight will only be heard in this very house, in this very moment. So that's exciting to hear what will only be during this very moment. And then any individual recognition sometimes can take away from the unity that we work really hard to present. So any individual name calling or things like that, save that for when they're running around the track or when they're shooting that discus or shot put or those kind of things from there. Without further ado, I'm going to invite the a cappellas to come up. They'll be starting our concert with a very well-known piece of music. The a cappellas are under the direction of me and also a student leader, a senior this year, Alex Heima. Here are the a cappellas.
Oh, we know it.
group that's right behind me, ready to perform. This is the ninth grade contingent of the male chorus group. Oftentimes you'll see them perform seventh, eighth, and ninth grade, but this is our ninth grade section. So these are our high schoolers here, except for the two on the end over here. We borrowed two eighth graders. This is Connor Wengler and Kai Skip. Will you help me thank them for being here? This piece they got a chance to perform at the concert last Thursday with the junior high, and now you get to hear the same piece except with these 10 leader voices. 12. Take a moment to recognize some people that work very diligently in order to make this many students be able to take choir every day. And in addition to all of the other requirements, Michigan places on these adolescents in order to graduate high school. Those people are Dr. Leiter, Ms. Alverson, and Mrs. Rabb. And some of them are even in the house tonight as well. So will you help me thank all of those wonderful level. We also have a superintendent. then that sees the bigger picture about how what we do at the high school doesn't start at the high school. It starts at the elementary schools. And Dr. Graham's vision of what the music program in Jenison can be like is what makes these students be just as amazing as they are on stage. So Dr. Graham, the administrative team at the grader level has also played a big part in making all of this happen. Behind me, the trumpet player is getting ready to perform. We've got two pieces. Strong from Cinderella, this was back in 2015. This message of the song diverts from the normal Disney princess model of just find this Prince Charming and then happily ever after will happen. This is be strong in your own skin, in your own self. So strongest verse, and then we'll do a jazz standard called This Can't Be Love. We'll welcome to the stage our two instrumentalists just further down from the piano, Ethan Brower and Ben Vanderburg. For Strong, we have Mrs. Alley on piano, and accompanying us on cajon is Mr. Kyle King. Up next, I'd like to welcome our first featured performer of the evening. Salma LaFried is going to be singing Orange Colored Sky. And as she was preparing for this featured performance spot, I got to hear her at auditions, and then I got to hear her again. And just the amount of changes and improvisation that she did between those two times, incredible. Then when I got to hear her today perform on this stage, again, a whole new piece of music. It was just like every time she performed it, there was new things, there's new stuff happening. Enjoy this. This is this improvisation skill is such a fun thing to do because it only happens once. So this is Salma, and also coming up to the stage is Corral is up next. So Corral will get into place just right after this piece. Salma LaFried, everybody. Next up to the stage, Corral is, as they're heading up, I'll just tell you a little bit. That Lonesome Road, originally made famous and written by James Taylor. So if there's any James Taylor fans in the house, this one's for you. And then after that, a Bill Withers tune, A Lovely Day. We were lucky enough last week on Monday to invite Gold Company into our classroom. And so we got to do a little exchange with Gold Company. If you aren't aware of Gold Company, they're a vocal jazz group from Western Michigan University, internationally renowned in the jazz world. And we got to have them in our classroom. It was just a fascinating experience and a lot of fun to get to exchange. And when they were there, we found out that Lovely Day, actually, when it was written and recorded, it initially had the longest note ever recorded in pop music. So, enjoy Lovely Day. The more you know, right?
seems impossible to face. When someone else is telling me, always seems to know the way.
Is also going to be coming up as Corel exits the stage. As the stage change is happening, we're going to welcome up to our stage Janae Desmukes, our second featured performer of the evening. She's going to sing a song, Feeling Good. Originally, I feel like I heard the Nina Simone version, but it's been covered a couple times. When I was talking to Janae earlier today, she was telling me about another cover that she had heard that kind of helped her style the piece. And initially, the piece was from a musical. Anybody know this, Feeling Good, from a musical? Okay. Do you know what musical? Calm yourself out over there, chamber singers. I might call you on it. It was called The Roar of Grease Paint and the Smell of the Crowd. Who knew? Roar, smell, it's the internet, I don't know. Got your mic already? Okay, have fun.
I'm gonna tell you all a little secret. I took off my glasses so I can't see anywhere.
Music always works best when you give the performer the pitch.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. Sleep in peace when the day.
blame her. I mean, really. Wow. Yes, they can sing amazingly, right? Yes, thank you. Thank you for letting them do this. Thank you. And you should also know that they are fabulous people to be around, too. They make me love my job. Thank you.
Look, look, look is up.
The dead battery up here. Would you like to just hear that beginning one more time? For our final feature performer, we're going to do a stage change, and then we're going to welcome up Gage Berkman and Gabriella Rose to perform the last feature performer of the evening. And then afterwards, we'll do two songs from Chamber Singers. They'll do a song called Soon It Will Be Done, and then their final song, You Will Be Found, is from the musical Dear Evan Hansen, just like what Gabby and Gage are about to sing. But let me make sure that they have a fresh battery so that you can hear both of them, and that's set to go.
Us and only us, and what came before won't come. not so possible. Nobody else but the two of us here.
Cause you're saying it's possible.
We can just watch the whole world disappear.
Till you're the only one. I still know how to see. It's just you and me.
I want to live with God. I'm going to live. and felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear?
Oh.
singers are about to take the stage for the final number. And as they do that, I just want to give a quick reminder. Tomorrow is seniors' final day, and it's also the day that if your singer wears one of those chamber singer dresses or one of the tuxedos, that is, tomorrow is the day that it comes back to school. We'll get those dry cleaned over the summer, and then they'll be ready and fresh for the fall. So just a reminder that those will come in. If you want to bring them in on a hanger and just put a piece of masking tape with your student's name, we'll make sure that we get that checked off as done for the end of the year. So if you just could remember that, that would be great. And I also like to recognize people that also work behind the scenes. These are our volunteers. These are the people that checked in the choirs tonight. These are the people that greeted you as ushers. These are the people that sit through booster meetings and make the big decisions with how we spend our fundraising dollars. So will you help me thank all of those volunteers? Finally, we would be remiss without recognizing the 2022 senior class, who makes up a large portion of our stage tonight. These singers have made it through a pandemic together. And not only have they made it through, but they also have brought a level of comedy and a level of leadership to the group. So they are just a great group of individuals, and I'm glad to share the stage with them tonight. As a token of our recognition, we'd like to, our boosters board is gonna help pass out a few gifts as they come down. So as you come down, if you could just make a line, seniors, we'll list you off here. I think they're coming on from backstage right now, this is perfect. Rachel Baroni, and we'll hold applause until the very end, and then we'll applaud for all the seniors. Rachel Baroni. Brady Blake.
Brady!
Should save those for graduation. Jada Boloma. Ella Bond. Logan Borsak. Tyler Curie. Sam Sear. Joanna DeBoer, Anthony Gilliam, Shy Holloway, Nate Hughes, Alex Simon, Abby Catchell, Liberty Casper, Natalie Linscott, Haley Redosa, Katie Sycamore, Lexi Urban, Reagan Veldkamp, Rafe Vleetstra, Kaylin Walcott, and Caitlin Markinty. And finally, we have a student that's only gonna be with us for this year, and then she's headed back to her home country of Andorra, which I didn't know, but is in between France and Spain. We're gonna add to this long line here, Noah Ruiz. Please help me congratulate and thank these seniors. Pleasure at this concert to get to award and recognize the two unsung hero Award Scholarship. This award recognizes two graduating seniors who give of their time, talent, and dedication to the choir program, but may not be in the spotlight for solos or other individualized performances. This scholarship is called the Unsung Hero Scholarship, and it's set up to recognize those students who continually give to the program, regardless of talent or desire, for featured or solo opportunities. Please help me congratulate Alex Heimer. Following our final number, if you'd like to stay and help, come on up to the stage. We're going to take down all these risers and shell pieces. You're welcome.
Thank you.